Well, hello. Our task in this chapter is to talk about using tasks.
Another pun, Scott. Really?
Yep.
Okay.
Keep coming. So tell us a little bit about what we're going to be talking about in this chapter.
Okay, so this chapter is about tasks. Now, when engineers or users are looking at a real-time operating system, what they're really looking for is a task. The way this thread works with signaling, topology, and so forth. So we're going to look at what is a task, what is the topology of a task, what is its structure, how is it signaled to run? Most of you probably have heard of the term semaphore. We're not going to really get into semaphores in this chapter, but we're going to talk about how our tasks run the next time and the next time, because it's kind of a while loop topology. And then we're going to do a lab that basically takes the GPIO interrupt. We're going to pull it out of idle. That's what we did in the last chapter. And we're actually going to put it inside a task. The signaling mechanism is pretty simple. We're going to sleep for 500 milliseconds, wake up, toggle the LED, and then go back to sleep for 500 milliseconds. All inside the task.
So we've actually looked at blinking an LED without an RTOS. We've looked at it with one thread type, idle. And in this chapter, we're going to take it to tasks, which is probably the thing that most people think about when they think about an RTOS, right?
In fact, we're going to be using tasks in all the rest of the chapters. So this is a fundamental thread type we really need to understand now, and we're going to use over and over again in the next chapters.
Okay, well then we better get right to it.
Absolutely.
So welcome to Chapter 7, Using Tasks. Okay, so goals and objectives. So our basic goal is to learn about tasks, how to create a task, and we're going to use that actually in the lab to blink an LED. So what do we need to know? What are some of the underlying objectives here? What is the task topology? So a task is a function that has a specific topology, and I'll explain why it has a prologue, loop, and epilogue. We'll discuss those terms. We'll talk about task scheduling in terms of its group priorities and relationship to SWEs and hardware interrupts. Compare and contrast different ways to create tasks. You can do it statically or dynamically, and we'll talk about why do one versus the other. When you do something dynamically, there is something called an error block. Basically, it's an error handling feature of TI-RTOS. Feature is a very nice name for it. We're going to talk about what to do with error block, what are your options with that. If you've heard of error block, we're going to discuss that. Then toward the end, this is one of those topics that, well, where do you put it? Do you put this in chapter 8 or 9 or 10? Well, it's in chapter 7. So when we talk about scheduling threads, there are certain common methods of going about figuring out how to schedule threads. So we'll talk about four of them that we know of and talk about two that we think are pretty good. So at the end of this chapter, we've got two labs, so part A and part B. So what are we going to do? In main, we're going to create a task for part A and tasks with an S in part B. So the part A, create one task. What is it going to do? It's going to sleep for 1,000 ticks. I haven't really described exactly what a tick is, but that's basically a second. Toggle an LED and then go back to sleep for another second, et cetera, et cetera. And we're going to build load, run that, look at that in ROV, and so forth. Then the second part of the lab gets a little more interesting when we add two tasks at the same priority level or different priority level, and they're going to sort of ping pong back and forth. So the second one will toggle the LED every 500 ticks. The other one will toggle the LED every 500 ticks. So we're back to a second toggle between the two of them. Okay, so as far as the outline goes, we'll start off talking about the topology of a task, what signals are used to synchronize it or unblock the task. Task API, so there are three or four that we're going to use specifically, but we want to kind of show the entire API list just to kind of give you a feel for what other task API are there. Then we'll move into how to create tasks. We're going to create tasks dynamically. You have a choice of doing it statically or dynamically, and most everything we're going to do in this workshop is dynamically. Then we'll talk about error block. That's a very short discussion. We'll give you three options to handle error block. Then we'll look at scheduling tasks. In other words, what does that look like in the scheduling diagram? We kind of looked at that in the last chapter in terms of when threads get scheduled, how does that work? You start off with BIOS start, you go to idle, and then as things happen, HWIs and SWEs and so forth. When you add tasks into the mix, what does that picture look like? And then we'll end with a short discussion on scheduling strategies, and then we'll move right into the two labs.